Welcome to another presentation about the Carolina Bays. This episode discusses the elliptical basins in Iowa that are analogous to the Carolina Bays and the Nebraska Rainwater Basins. The glacier ice impact hypothesis proposes that these elliptical features were created from oblique impacts of glacier ice ejected by one or more extraterrestrial impacts on the Laurentide ice sheet. I have received several notes from Austin Cole Carlisle suggesting locations of elliptical features that have not been marked in the LIDAR visualization survey by Michael Davies. Austin's latest notes said, "By the way, I wanted to send you some elliptical features I found recently in the Midwest, and they aren't Kettle Lakes. I know you are focusing on Saginaw, but some of these and the adjacent features do orient to the Great Lakes region. But I wanted to mainly present you these because of their elliptical geometry." It is true that I have relied on Saginaw Bay as the epicenter of an extraterrestrial impact based on a paper published by Davies and Gilbride in 2010. However, a chart of the orientations of the Carolina Bays, Nebraska Rainwater Basins, and other elliptical structures in several states shows multiple convergence points, not only one. The main intersection point is in Wisconsin, which adjusted for the rotation of the Earth corresponds to Lake Michigan. We are going to start by examining the basin just to the northeast of Grafton, Iowa. The satellite image of this area does not show any evidence of the basins. We can only see some crop fields and the town of Grafton, which was founded in 1878 following the construction of the Chicago, Milwaukee, and St. Paul Railway. A train depot was completed by the railroad the following year. A closer look at the LIDAR image shows the faint angular outline of a farm, the railroad tracks, and the county highway S-62 that slices through the rims of two adjacent basins. The basins are totally hidden by the cornfields in the satellite image. LIDAR, which stands for Light Detection and Ranging, is a remote sensing method that uses light from a laser to measure distances to the Earth. LIDAR has completely changed the study of the Carolina Bays by revealing the contours of the terrain in spite of the vegetation. The street view of Google Maps from County Highway S-62 shows a cornfield, the farm buildings, and the railroad tracks. Carolina Bays are characterized by their elliptical geometry because they originated as inclined conical cavities. We can try to fit an ellipse to this geological feature by selecting points along the perimeter of the structure. Portions of the rim basin have been destroyed by the corner of the farm, by the railroad tracks, and by plowing for the cultivation of crops. It is not possible to determine the perimeter of the basin at these locations, so no points are selected here. I used a Python program to fit an ellipse to the selected points using the least squares method. The fit of the ellipse is very good. All the points on the perimeter of the basin fall along the elliptical path. This geological structure has all the characteristics of a Carolina Bay. It has raised rims, elliptical geometry, and as we will see, it is oriented toward the Great Lakes. This is a Carolina Bay. Based on the rim adjacent to the highway, we expect to see another similar elliptical basin, but only the western part of the basin is visible on LIDAR. Going back to the satellite image, we can draw a red line along the margin of the cornfield. It is evident that the eastern part of the basin has been completely destroyed by agricultural activity. The Carolina Bays are fragile sandy structures that are easily eroded. The town of Grafton was founded in 1878. This means that farming has erased the east half of the basin in less than 146 years. The ease with which the Carolina Bays can be destroyed is a clue that the bays must be of recent geological origin. There are multiple lines of evidence indicating that the bays formed toward the end of the Ice Age in the late Pleistocene epoch. This slide compares the satellite image from 2020 on the left and an aerial view published by Professor Douglas Johnson in 1942 on the right. The two images illustrate that the sand rims of the Carolina Bays are disappearing. The image from Johnson's book has broad, well-defined sandy rims, but on the contemporary satellite image, the sandy rims have been reduced to thin outlines during the past 78 years. This degradation of the terrain has happened even though these bays are in the protected area called the Little PD Heritage Preserve. We now shift our attention to the small basin on the right of this image. The basin has a well-defined rim. It has an elliptical shape with a length of 90 meters. As in the previous case, the basin cannot be seen in the satellite image. The ice projectile that made the basin by Grafton, Iowa, would have measured approximately 47 meters in diameter, which is about one-fifth of the basin length. This is consistent with the proportions of the conical structures made by experimental impacts on viscous targets. The elliptical basin has an azimuth of 272.6 degrees, which leads directly to Lake Michigan at a distance of 445 kilometers. Using ballistic equations, we can calculate that the glacier ice boulder that made this basin was launched at a speed of 2.1 kilometers per second. It had a flight time of 4.7 minutes and reached a height of 96 kilometers above the surface of the Earth. The trajectory did not quite reach the 100 kilometer height that defines the limit of Earth's atmosphere and the beginning of space. The energy of the impact that made this basin was equivalent to 27 kilotons of TNT and would have produced seismic vibrations of magnitude 6.4. In general, seismic vibrations of magnitude 6.0 or above can cause saturated soil to liquefy, as happened during the 2011 earthquake in Christchurch, New Zealand. The origin of the Carolina Bays has been greatly debated. The mainstream theories propose that these geological structures were created by wind blowing on ponded water. However, ellipses are conic sections, and the precise elliptical geometry of the bays implies that these features originated as inclined conical cavities or penetration funnels. Experiments demonstrate that viscous relaxation reduces the depth of inclined conical cavities to create shallow elliptical basins that look elliptical when viewed from above. The glacier ice impact hypothesis, published in 2017, proposes that an extraterrestrial impact on the Laurentide ice sheet ejected pieces of ice, and the secondary oblique impacts created the Carolina Bays and the Nebraska Rainwater Basins. The date of the extraterrestrial impact can be deduced from the contextual evidence from advances and retreats of the ice sheets, from dates published for the bays by various researchers, and from ecological markers based on the energy of the glacier ice bombardment. The 2023 paper by Andrew Wickert and seven co-authors provides maps of the ice coverage that can be used to deduce the time of emplacement of the Carolina Bays and other impact basins. By overlaying a semi-transparent image of the last glacial maximum from Wickert, we can see that many Carolina Bays in Iowa are in the area that was covered with ice from 26,000 to 18,700 years ago by the Des Moines lobe of the ice sheet. The image by Wickert represents a time period of 7,300 years, and the ice sheet advanced and retreated substantially during this time. This LiDAR image highlights the moraine of the Des Moines lobe that marks the advance of the glacier during the last glacial maximum. A moraine is a mass of rocks and sediment carried by a glacier, which is deposited when the glacier melts. The movement of the glacier created some level terrain where Carolina Bays could form after the ice retreated. This means that the Carolina Bays in Iowa are younger than 18,700 years. Long Island in New York was created by accumulations of rock debris deposited by retreating glaciers during the Ice Age. The Ronkonkoma Moraine was in place about 55,000 years ago, and there are some Carolina Bays on top of this terrain. A northern moraine called the Harbor Hill Moraine was formed after the retreat of the Wisconsin Glacier, which reached its most southward advance about 18,000 years ago. This glacier completely melted in the New York City region approximately 13,000 to 12,000 years ago. Since Carolina Bays cannot form from impacts on top of an ice sheet, this means that the Carolina Bays in Long Island could be younger than 18,000 years, taking into consideration the data from Wickert. A wide range of dates have been published for the Carolina Bays. A paper by Brooks and two co-authors produced dates ranging from 2.2 to 74.3 thousand years ago using optically stimulated luminescence. Except for one recent date, all these dates are within the range of the Wisconsin glaciation. We have to keep in mind that the impacts that created the bays would have scrambled the stratigraphy of the terrain, so the dates only provide a rough estimate of the geological time when the bays were emplaced. A 2001 paper by Zanner and Kusila says that the Nebraska rainwater basins exist on top of a terrain that has been dated to about 27,000 years before the present. This means that the Carolina Bays and the Nebraska basins, which are also elliptical, are younger than 27,000 years if they formed contemporaneously from the same extraterrestrial event. Let us now consider the ecological consequences of the extraterrestrial impact that created the Carolina Bays. This chart of the Earth's temperature during the last million years shows the time intervals during which it would have been possible to meet the conditions necessary for the formation of the Carolina Bays. The Wisconsin glaciation extended from approximately 75,000 to 11,000 years ago, and there were several times when ice advanced to cover the Great Lakes. The Younger Dryas was a cold period at the end of the Wisconsin glaciation starting 12,900 years ago that lasted about 1,200 years. The maximum ice extent occurred approximately 25,000 to 21,000 years ago during the last glacial maximum. This graph shows the extinctions during the last 56,000 years. Many animals went extinct at the Younger Dryas boundary 12,900 years ago. There are other extinctions in this 56,000-year time interval, but the most severe and sudden extinction was at the onset of the Younger Dryas 12,900 years ago. Previously, I calculated the energy required to make the Carolina Bays in a 4-square-kilometer area in Marlborough County, South Carolina. When we add the energy required to create the Carolina Bays in the 4-square-kilometer area, we get a total of 31,794 kilotons or 31.8 megatons of TNT. Dividing by 4, we get an energy of 7.95 megatons per square kilometer. With this tremendous bombardment, all the megafauna like the mammoths, short-faced bears, giant armadillos, and all the forest plants would have been ground into a paste. Look at this LiDAR image of Carolina Bays located 25 kilometers southwest from Fayetteville, North Carolina. Interstate Highway I-95 appears as a thin line on the right portion of the image. All the image is covered with Carolina Bays. The emplacement of the bays was a saturation bombardment from which there was no escape. It would have been impossible to survive the horrific hailstorm of impacts with energy of 8 megatons per square kilometer. For this reason, an extinction event has to be associated with the origin of the Carolina Bays. The range of the ballistic trajectories was approximately 1,500 kilometers from the Great Lakes. A paper by Vance Haynes published in 2008 shows the location of the black mats found at the Younger Dryas boundary. The black mats resulted from vegetation that was smothered by ice crystals and snow deposited beyond the range of the ballistic sedimentation. Animals that were outside of the 1,500-kilometer kill zone of the ejecta curtain could have survived, but they would have had to adapt to the colder climate of the Younger Dryas cooling event that lasted 1,200 years. One characteristic of impact craters is the inverted stratigraphy of the rims. If we obtain a core sample from the rim of an impact crater, we would see the youngest material in the top layer, followed by older material excavated by the projectile from a deeper layer. And going deeper, we would find the young material that was the surface of the terrain at the time of the impact. A publication by Ted Bunch and 17 co-authors in 2012 described the core sample from the rim of a Carolina Bay. At the time that the paper was written, the Carolina Bays were thought to have formed by gradualistic wind and water mechanisms, so the significance of the inverted stratigraphy was not recognized. The authors write, quote, "The two dates at 107 and 183 centimeters below the surface were used to generate an H-depth model, excluding the sample at 152 centimeters below the surface because of the large magnitude of the H reversal, that is, older sediments lying stratigraphically higher than younger sediments." End quote. The sample at 183 centimeters below the surface seems to correspond to the surface at the time of the extraterrestrial impact approximately 12,900 years ago. The glacier ice impact hypothesis has been contested using the argument that there was no ice in Saginaw Bay 12,900 years ago at the time of the extraterrestrial event. However, the latest data from Wickert shows that Lake Michigan was covered with ice at this time, and this is the convergence point of many of the Carolina Bays and Nebraska rainwater basins. The evidence for an extraterrestrial impact had been elusive until 2013, when Petayev and 3 co-authors found a high concentration of platinum in the core from a Greenland ice sheet at the level corresponding to 12,900 years ago. The authors concluded that the extraterrestrial source of platinum could have been from the impact of an iron meteorite with low iridium content. Recent papers have found that platinum from this event is widely distributed and that the platinum-enriched layers can be used for chronostratigraphy. In conclusion, most of the radiocarbon and OSL dates reported for the Carolina Bays are in the range of 11,000 to 30,000 years ago. The presence of Carolina Bays in Long Island and Iowa indicates that the bays could not be older than 18,000 years because these areas were covered with ice earlier. The dates by Ted Bunch of the inverted stratigraphy in the rim of a Carolina Bay are the most relevant because they prove that the bays are impact structures and show a base layer with a date of 12,900 years ago. The platinum anomaly indicates that there was an extraterrestrial impact 12,900 years ago, and the projectile had the characteristics necessary to have ejected glacier ice boulders after impacting the Laurentide ice sheet. The extinction of the megafauna in North America coincides with the time of the extraterrestrial impact. The energetic bombardment by the secondary impacts of glacier ice would have triggered an extinction event within a 1,500-kilometer radius from the Great Lakes. The emplacement of the Carolina Bays from the secondary impacts of glacier ice 12,900 years ago at the Younger Dryas boundary seems reasonable considering the reported dates and the ecological considerations. All the evidence of erosion indicates that the Carolina Bays formed relatively recently in geological time. Taking into consideration the advances and retreats of the ice sheets, the multitude of dates obtained by various researchers, and ecological considerations based on the energy of the secondary glacier ice bombardment, we can say that the extraterrestrial impact event responsible for the creation of the Carolina Bays happened approximately 12,900 years ago. Thank you for joining me in the investigation of the Carolina Bays and the Younger Dryas Cataclysm. The Carolina Bays should not be neglected. Tell your geology professors to include the Carolina Bays in their books because they are the most prevalent geological structures in the Atlantic coastal plain. There's a link to the LiDAR visualization tool by Michael Davies in the description of the video. My book about the Carolina Bays is available at Amazon. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel to be notified of future videos about the Carolina Bays and other scientific topics.